ഹലോ മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, വെൽക്കം ബാക്ക് ടു ആൻ അനദർ എപ്പിസോഡ് ഓഫ് ബേസിക് സയൻസ് ക്ലാസ്. ഹൗ ആർ യു ഓൾ മൈ ഡിയേഴ്സ്? ഐ ഹോപ്പ് എവറി വൺ ഓഫ് യു ആർ ഡൂയിങ് വെൽ നൗ. ഡു യു റിമെമ്പർ വാട്ട് യു സ്റ്റഡീഡ് ഇൻ ദ പ്രീവിയസ് യൂണിറ്റ്, ലൈഫ് വിതിൻ ദ സീഡ്സ്? വാട്ട് യു സ്റ്റഡീഡ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് യൂണിറ്റ്? ദ മെയിൻ പോയിൻറ്റ്സ് വി ഡിസ്കസ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് യൂണിറ്റ് വെയർ ജെർമിനേഷൻ ഓഫ് സീഡ്സ്. എയർ, വാട്ടർ ആൻഡ് ഫേവറബിൾ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ആർ ദ എസൻഷ്യൽ ഫോർ ദ ജെർമിനേഷൻ ഓഫ് സീഡ്സ്. ദൻ ജെർമിനേഷൻ, വാട്ട് ഈസ് ജെർമിനേഷൻ? ജെർമിനേഷൻ ഈസ് ദ പ്രോസസ് ഓഫ് ദി എംബ്രിയോ ഇൻസൈഡ് ദ സീഡ് ഗ്രോയിങ് ഇൻ ടു സീഡ്ലിംഗ് അണ്ടർ ഫേവറബിൾ സർക്കംസ്റ്റൻസസ്. ദൻ വെജിറ്റേറ്റീവ് പ്രൊപ്പഗേഷൻ, വാട്ട് ഈസ് വെജിറ്റേറ്റീവ് പ്രൊപ്പഗേഷൻ? Vegetative propagation is the formation of new plants from vegetative parts of plants like root, stem and leaf. Then dispersal of seeds. Seeds disperse through water by bursting, etc. Do you remember all these things? Yes. Now we move on to the new unit. Do you know? Yeah. Energy sources. What is energy? Do you have energy? Energy is the capacity to do work. You also have energy. That is why you all do studying, playing, sleeping, etc. If we don't have energy, we can't do anything. What were the things you have seen in that pictures? You have seen images of firewood stove, kerosene stove and a gas stove. There are varieties of stoves. Which type of stove is used in your houses? In your houses, any one of these is used for cooking, isn't it? Do you know how heat is produced in a firewood stove? Which substance used to produce heat in firewood stove? It is firewood. What are the substances used in kerosene stoves and gas stoves? In kerosene stoves, kerosene is used. In gas stoves, commonly LPG is used. Which substances are used for running vehicle? Usually petrol and diesel are used in vehicles. Here you said about some substances. Which are the substances? They are firewood, then kerosene, LPG, petrol and diesel. We call these substances as what? Do you know? These are fuels. What are fuels? Firewood, kerosene, petrol, diesel are fuels. What will happen if these fuels burned? What will happen? They produce heat. Fuels produce heat when they burn. If fuels produce heat, what are fuels? Fuels are substances which liberate heat energy while burning. Fuels produce which energy when they burn? Fuels produce heat energy. Now you understand that what are fuels. Which fuels are used for cooking? Firewood, kerosene, LPG, biogas, solar energy are used for cooking. Which fuels are used for running vehicles? Commonly petrol and diesel are used for running vehicles. Fuels are available in three states: fuels are found in the state of solids, liquids and gases. Firewood and coal are solid fuels. Diesel, petrol and kerosene are liquid fuels. Liquid fuels are the components separated from petroleum. LPG, CNG and hydrogen are gaseous fuels. All fuels are sources of energy. What is the source of your energy? It is food. Food is the source of our energy. We use fuels in our daily life. There are so many uses of fuels. Fuels are used for cooking, producing electricity in automobiles, making medicines, pesticides in cosmetics. Fuels are used in motor cars and buses. Petrol and diesel are commonly used in vehicles. From where the vehicles get energy for running? From the fuels used in it. The energy required for running vehicles is obtained from the fuels used in it. Do you know which fuel is used in aeroplane? It is aviation fuel. Aviation fuel is used in aeroplanes. Fuels produce energy by burning. Hence, all fuels are sources of energy. Excessive use of fuels causes atmospheric pollution and it affects our health also. We do loads of activities in daily life. From where we get energy for doing all these activities? From the food. Energy is needed for all our activities. Our source of energy is what? It is food. Take a look to the picture. How fuels are burned? Do fuels burn on their own? Do you remember the experiment? Here, one of your friend is doing an experiment. Watch it. What happened to that burning candle when the glass is covered? What happened to the flame of the candle? The candle flame put out. What did you understand from that experiment? Air is also needed for burning things. Fuel alone is not sufficient for burning things. Air is also required for the burning of any substances. Fuels require air for burning. It is the oxygen in the air helps burning. Presence of which substance in the air helps burning? It is oxygen. Fuels liberate energy by reacting with oxygen in the air. In our body also, food reacts with oxygen to produce energy. How oxygen enters into our body? Through breathing. Now you understood that firewood burns well in a stove only with an adequate supply of air. Here you look to this picture. Women in that image blows a pipe into the firewood stove to burn firewood. That pipe helps to allow enough supply of air to the firewoods. It helps to the burning of fuels. Now you understand that the qualities of a better firewood stove. What are qualities needed for a better firewood stove? While using a firewood stove, do not pack the stove with excess firewood. Make sure adequate air supply. Firewood should be cut into pieces before being placed in the stove. Firewood should be utilized completely. Clean the stove every day. Clean the chimney once a month. Which type of stoves are used in your houses? Is in this ways stoves are used in your houses? If not, adopt these techniques. This will help to reduce consumption of large amount of fuels here, firewood. This can save our trees some extent. These measures reduce air pollution and also need little time for cooking food. A good stove produces maximum heat from the fuel used. There should be smooth air circulation. The heat produced should reach the vessel fully. This helps to make cooking easier and to save fuels. There should be provision for smoke to escape. Now you look at these images. What that images convey? Large number of vehicles. This is the everyday sight of major cities in the world. We understood that vehicles need fuels. All these vehicles consume large amount of fuels daily. Not in vehicles only, in all industries fuels are used largely. What will be the consequences in future of the excessive uses of fuels? Most of the energy sources are exhaustible. If we don't use these sources wisely, these will extinct. Most of these energy sources are non-renewable, not formed easily again, most of these fuels. Watch these images. You have seen images of energy sources, images of petroleum refinery, solar panel, windmill. These are our most energy sources. Which are they? Petroleum refinery, solar panel, windmills. Petrol, diesel, etc. separated from crude oil in the refinery. From the petroleum refinery, the components like petrol, diesel, etc. are separated. Then from the solar panel, we use solar energy. From the windmill, wind energy is used through windmill. Among these energy sources, some are exhaustible and others are inexhaustible. Which are inexhaustible? Solar energy and wind energy are inexhaustible. Petrol and diesel are exhaustible. These are fossil fuels. Petrol and diesel are formed from fossils. They are conventional energy sources. Conventional means early or old methods. Thank you. you know how petroleum is formed? Petroleum is formed from decayed living organisms buried deep under the earth for millions of years due to some natural phenomenon like floods, earthquake, eruption of volcanoes. Coal is formed from plant remains. These are fossil fuels. Such fuels cannot be replenished once they get exhausted. They are called conventional fuels. In future, conventional fuels will get exhausted if not wisely used. Petroleum is mainly used to produce petrol, diesel, kerosene, tar, and LPG. In addition, it is used in the manufacture of many products like pesticides, plastics, medicines, cosmetics, etc. Non-conventional means comparatively new methods. Non-conventional energy sources are solar energy, wind, and sea waves. These energy sources are inexhaustible. What are the advantages of making maximum use of non-conventional sources of energy for our needs? Write down it in your science diary. Now, I am showing some solar devices. Among these, which devices are used in your houses? List down such devices. Do you know one of our international airports is working under solar panels? Which airport is that? It is Nedumbasheri International Airport. It is in Kochi. Solar devices use energy from sunlight. In solar devices, solar cells convert solar energy into electrical energy. Solar panels contain rows of solar cells. These are rectangular panels made of silicon. The advantages of energy from inexhaustible resources doesn't cause pollution. Lamps, cookers, water heaters, and calculators working with solar energy are widely used nowadays. Wind energy is another non-conventional energy source. Windmills produce energy from wind. Windmills produce energy. The blades of the mill rotate by the power of wind. This rotation leads to the working of the generator. Thus, electricity is produced. Non-conventional energy sources are everlasting and eco-friendly. In our daily life, fuels are being wasted in various instances. Charcoal and firewood are wasted if we don't use the remains of it. When we use private vehicles rather than public transport for travel, widespread use of luxury vehicles, many of them have poor fuel efficiency. The purpose of a bulb is to produce light. When the bulb gets heated up, it causes loss of energy. The filament bulb requires more electricity to work. But CFL bulbs give the same amount of light, requires less electricity. Hence, CFL is better to save energy. LED lamps are also capable of saving greater amount of energy are now available in the market. What steps can be taken to save energy at your houses? Limit the use of conventional energy sources, then use fuel efficient firewood stove, use biogas plants. Don't waste our energy sources. Use it wisely and properly. We conserve energy sources when we don't waste fuels. December 14th is observed as National Conservation Day. The theme of that day is conserving energy is equal to producing energy. The consumption of fuel is increasing day by day. If we don't use these fuels wisely, energy crisis will occur in future. Only through strict control of the consumption of fuels like coal and petroleum and maximum utilization of non-conventional energy sources can the energy crisis be overcome in future. Let us recollect what we studied in this unit. Energy is the capacity to do work. Then we discussed about fuels. Fuels are substances which liberate heat while burning. Fuels are available in solid, liquid, and gaseous form. The air is needed for burning things. Presence of oxygen in the air helps burning. Then we discussed about the features of good firewood stove. Then we discussed about conventional and non-conventional energy sources. Then discussed about the advantages of non-conventional energy sources. Then we discussed about the advantages of saving energy. I hope you enjoyed today's basic science class. We will meet you in next class. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Love you all.